Good afternoon to all of you. Welcome back to the chemistry lecture. Yesterday I could not conduct the lecture because of some network issue. Okay. So today we'll start our chapter number 3, that is crystal field theory. It is also called as CFT, crystal field theory. It is also called as CFT. Okay. I think we have completed 2 chapters, correct? Yes or no? We have finished 2 chapters, that is introduction to the coordination chemistry we have seen, then valence bond theory also we have completed. Yes or no? Bolo jaldi se. Or no? Tell me. Yes, Rohan is saying yes. Okay, chalo. So today we will start with crystal field theory, which is very, very important chapter. Important in the sense of, your coordination chemistry, to understand your coordination chemistry, or in other word you can say it is important as far as your career is concerned. Because if you want to clear NET set exam, or any competitive exam related to the chemistry, for example while joining the PhD or any other competitive exams, this CFT is very, very important. Both se sare questions CFT ke based hi puche jate. Okay, so CFT is it is better than valence bond theory. That's why there are some advantages of CFT over the valence bond theory. Whatever the drawbacks of valence bond theory, that drawbacks has overcome by the crystal field theory. So this is the need of your crystal field theory. ठीक है, क्या नीड है? जो कुछ भी ड्रॉबैक थे वैलेंस बॉन्ड थ्योरी के, फॉर एग्जांपल वन ड्रॉबैक इज वी कैन नॉट एक्सप्लेन व्हाई सर्टेन कॉम्प्लेक्सेस हैव कैलकुलेटेड मैग्नेटिक मोमेंट और एक्सपेरिमेंटल मैग्नेटिक मोमेंट मोर देन थ्योरेटिकल मैग्नेटिक मोमेंट. इसका आंसर सीएफटी के पास नहीं था. वन मोर आंसर, व्हाई सर्टेन कॉम्प्लेक्सेस has coordination number 4, but still they shows different types of geometries. For example, if coordination number 4 if the complex has coordination number 4, then it can have either tetrahedral or square planar geometry. So why this is so? Iska bhi koi bhi answer nahi tha CFT ke paas. Then one more, why certain complexes for strong field why certain ligand forms strong field complexes and why another forms weak field complexes, or how to determine whose ligands which ligands are strong field ligands and which ligands are weak field ligands. Iska bhi answer nahi tha. So whatever the jo kuch bhi drawbacks the CFT ke, that drawback has overcome by the crystal field theory. So this crystal field theory is better than the valence bond theory, but still crystal field theory has some drawback that we will see at the end of this chapter. Okay, so this theory explains the bonding of the molecules, especially coordination compounds, or we can say ionic compounds. Then it will determines the magnetic property, physical properties, especially magnetic properties. So according to the CFT, or we can calculate the exact magnetic moment of the complex by using the CFT. Okay, so these are the some importance. I have this question paper. Ye jo question paper hai na, wo last year ke backlog ka question paper hai. Can you see this? Aur isme more than 10% jo aapke question the na, more than 10% question aapke CFT ke the. Okay, so if you want, I will tell you some questions. For example, what is the electronic configuration for d8-ion in strong field octadal complexes in terms of T2G and EG? So you have to answer what is the T2G orbital and what is the EG orbital, that we are seeing. So different questions are there. ये जो आपका recent है, refresh, fresh वाला ये question paper है, जो कि अभी 2-3 दिन पहले हुआ था, backlog का question paper है, TYBSC का, ठीक है? So this chapter is very, very important. ठीक है? So we will start with our chapter number 3, that is crystal field theory. Okay, okay. So So this is the first lecture. This is the first lecture of crystal field theory. Lecture number one of crystal field theory. ठीक है. So are you guys ready? कौन कौन तैयार है crystal field theory और new chapter के लिए? Please tell me. मुझे पता लग जाएगा कि कौन कौन आया है lecture में. ठीक है. बोलो. Yes sir. Comment में लिख दो. मिहिर, चेतन, प्रीतम, गुड. व्हाट अबाउट अदर्स? ओनली विश्वजीत, सुप्रिया, ग्रीषा, दीक्षा, पूजा, सौरभ, विक्रम, रेणुका, संस्कृति, जयेश, वैभव, प्रियंका, कृष्ण प्रिया. वेरी गुड, कृष्ण प्रिया भी आ गई है. देन रोहन सोनू ने. ठीक है. सो वील स्टार्ट द न्यू चैप्टर, चैप्टर नंबर 3. Amit is there. That is crystal field theory. ठीक है. So this we will see some introduction first of all. Who proposed this theory? What is the need of this theory that we have seen? So we will start with the first introductory part. So this theory was proposed by the scientist. Two scientists was there. This theory was proposed by the scientist H. Bethe and Van Leck in 1929. So this theory was proposed or put forth by the scientist. That is H. Bethe and Van Leck in 1929. So these two scientists, that is Van Bethe and Van Leck, applied this theory to the ionic compound. So they have solved the ionic compound based on the CFT. But Orgel, one more scientist there, Orgel ne ye theory wo widely use kiya tha. Orgel ne is theory ko, Orgel applied this theory to the all chemical compounds. So the क्रेडिट गोज टू द ऑर्गेल. ऑर्गेल ने, दिस इज ऑल्सो द नेम ऑफ साइंटिस्ट, ऑर्गेल ऐसा साइंटिस्ट था कि जिसने सीएफटी को पूरे केमिकल कंपाउंड को अप्लाई किया था. और जो एच बेथे और वैन लेक, उन्होंने ये थेरी अप्लाई की थी फर्स्ट टाइम. और ये थेरी उन्होंने अप्लाई की थी फॉर द आयोनिक कंपाउंड ओनली, फॉर द आयोनिक कंपाउंड ओनली. सो दीज आर द्री साइंटिस्ट जिन्होंने की ये थेरी को अप्लाई किया है, एक्सटेंड किया है. ठीक है. और ड्रेव क्या है, वी कैन से इन्होंने ये थ्योरी को बॉर्न दिया है, जन्म दिया है, एच बेथे, वैन लेक एंड ऑर्गेल. ठीक है. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वील स्टार्ट विथ सम इम्पॉर्टेंट टर्म्स, और देर आर सम बेसिक नॉलेज यू शुड हैव बिफोर गोइंग टू द सीएफटी. सो विच टर्म्स यू शुड नो? सो फर्स्ट टर्म इज लिगेंड्स, और टाइप्स ऑफ लिगेंड यू मस्ट नो. सो फर्स्ट आपको क्या होना चाहिए, लिगेंड और उसके टाइप्स पता होने चाहिए. मीन्स विच टाइप, स्ट्रॉन्ग फील्ड, वीक फील्ड एंड एवरेज लिगेंड. ठीक है. देन सेकेंड पॉइंट इज सेंट्रल मेटल एटम. सेंट्रल मेटल के बारे में आप लोगों को कुछ पता होना चाहिए. सो क्या पता होना चाहिए आप लोगों को, व्हाट शुड यू नो? द फर्स्ट इज एटॉमिक नंबर, दिस इज ऑल्सो इम्पोर्टेंट. ये मैंने आपको वैलेंस बॉन्ड थ्योरी के टाइम पे भी बोला था. सो यू शुड नो अबाउट द एटॉमिक नंबर ऑफ एटलीस्ट डी ब्लॉक मेटल्स. यू शुड नो एटॉमिक नंबर ऑफ एटलीस्ट डी ब्लॉक मेटल्स. ठीक है, वो बहुत ही इंपॉर्टेंट है. देन इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्फ़िगरेशन ऑफ दैट मेटल, और वैलेंस शेल इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्फ़िगरेशन, VSEC, इट इज कॉल्ड एज वैलेंस शेल इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्फ़िगरेशन. एंड प्लीज रिमेंबर दैट, प्लीज रिमेंबर दिस, व्हाइल राइटिंग द इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्फ़िगरेशन, डी ऑर्बिटल स्टार्ट्स विद प्रिंसिपल क्वांटम नंबर n इज इक्वल टू 3, व्हिच इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. द प्रिंसिपल क्वांटम नंबर ऑफ डी ऑर्बिटल इज स्टार्ट्स विद 3. ये आप लोगों को पता होना चाहिए. क्या पता होना चाहिए? द प्रिंसिपल क्वांटम नंबर ऑफ डी ऑर्बिटल्स आर अ डी ब्लॉक एलिमेंट स्टार्ट्स विद n इज इक्वल टू 3. सो n की वैल्यू जो है d की, उसका और डी ब्लॉक डी ऑर्बिटल की, वो n इज इक्वल टू 3 से स्टार्ट होती है. दिस इज ऑल्सो, देन यू शुड एबल टू कैलकुलेट द ऑक्सीडेशन स्टेट. दिस इज ऑल्सो वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. आप लोगों को ऑक्सीडेशन स्टेट ऑफ एनी कॉम्प्लेक्स की डिटरमाइन करने आनी ही चाहिए. ठीक है. देन द वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट इज शेप्स ऑफ द डी ऑर्बिटल. सो दिस डी ऑर्बिटल प्लेज इंपॉर्टेंट रोल इन सीएफटी. D orbital plays important role in CFT. So it is necessary to study the shapes of the D orbital. You should know the shapes of the D orbital. You know there are 5 D orbitals are present. कितने D orbitals होते? So total 5 D orbitals होते. 5 D orbitals. Which 5 D orbitals are there? Can anybody tell me? कौन से 5d ऑर्बिटल होते हैं, द नेम ऑफ द 5d ऑर्बिटल्स, एनीबॉडी नोज, आई हैव टोल्ड यू करेक्ट, ग्रीशा, एक्स वाई, एक्स जेड, डी वाई, डी एक्स स्क्वायर माइनस वाई स्क्वायर एंड डी जेड स्क्वायर, वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, ठीक है, ओके, देन सो ये ऑर्बिटल्स होते हैं, सो फर्स्ट डी एक्स वाई, डी एक्स जेड, डी वाई जेड एंड डी एक्स स्क्वायर माइनस वाई स्क्वायर एंड डी जेड स्क्वायर, दीज 5d ऑर्बिटल्स आर देयर, सो देर इज अ डिफरेंस बिटवीन डी एक्स वाई एंड डी एक्स स्क्वायर माइनस वाई स्क्वायर, ठीक है, बहुत से सारे बच्चों का कंफ्यूजन हो जाता है, डी एक्स वाई एंड डी एक्स स्क्वायर माइनस वाई स्क्वायर, दे थिंक दैट दिस टू आर द सेम, बट दिस टू आर नॉट सेम, डी एक्स स्क्वायर माइनस वाई स्क्वायर इज डिफरेंट एंड डी एक्स वाई इज डिफरेंट, सो विच डिफरेंस इज देयर, व्हाट डिफरेंस इज देयर इन बिटवीन दिस टू ऑर्बिटल, आई विल टेल यू, ठीक है, सो द शेप्स ऑफ द डी ऑर्बिटल इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, ठीक है, सो वील डिस्कस और वील सी द डिफरेंट शेप्स ऑफ द डी ऑर्बिटल, यू नो दैट p orbitals are dumbbell shape, p orbitals are dumbbell shape and d orbitals are the shape of the d orbitals hai pata kisi ko, p orbitals are dumbbell shape and the shape of d orbital is, anybody knows the shape of d orbital, the shape of the d orbital is doubly dumbbell shape, the shape of the d orbital is doubly dumbbell shape, so we will see first of all the shapes of the d orbital, theek hai, okay, so this is the first, yeah correct, prachi ne sahi bola, doubly dumbbell shape, theek hai, so we will see the shapes of the d orbital, krishnapriya also is saying doubly dumbbell shape, डबल डम्बल शेप होते हैं, ठीक है, सो शेप ऑफ द डी ऑर्बिटल्स, फर्स्ट वी विल सी द दिस डी ऑर्बिटल डी एक्स वाई, वी विल सी द डी ऑर्बिटल दैट इज डी एक्स वाई, सो द डी इज, डी स्टैंड्स फॉर डी ऑर्बिटल एक्स वाई, मीन्स दिस एक्स एक्सिस इज देयर, वाई एक्सिस इज देयर एंड जेड एक्सिस इज देयर एंड दिस डी एक्स वाई मीन्स दिस डी एक्स वाई ऑर्बिटल विल हैव देयर लोब इन बिटवीन दिस एक्स एंड वाई, this dxy means its lobes are in between the x and y orbital, so this is x orbital, here will be x dash, yahan pe kya kaun sa jayega x dash, so this is y, here will be the y dash, here z, it will be the z dash, theek hai, so this is the one axis, this is one axis, that is y axis, this is another axis, that is x axis and if you see their lobes are in between these axes, ye jo aapko dikh raha hai green color sa, its lobe is in between the this dx y, here also if you see here doubly dumbbell shape rehte, so this is the shapes, I will write here, theek hai, I will write here. Suppose this is your x orbital and this is your y orbital. So their lobes are in between the axes. So this is this plus and minus sign. This sign is called as a symmetry sign. So this is dxy orbital, this is dxy orbital, so the lobes lies in between this x and y orbital, okay, understood what is the meaning of dxy, yes or no, samajh mein aaya, what is the meaning of this dxy, the meaning is the orbital which has its lobes in between the x and y axis, in between the x and y axis, okay, very good, ठीक है, देन वी विल गो टू द नेक्स्ट इज डी एक्स जेड, डी एक्स जेड मीन्स इट्स लोब्स आर इन बिटवीन द एक्स एंड जेड एक्सेस, देयर लोब्स आर इन बिटवीन द एक्स एंड जेड एक्सेस, सपोज दिस इज एक्स ऑर्बिटल एंड दिस इज जेड ऑर्बिटल, देन द ऑर्बिटल इज लुक लाइक दिस, सो दिस इज द dxz orbital, this is dxz orbital, Okay, understood? Then we will see the next. Next is dxy. This is dxy, and its slope is in between the x and y axis. Its slope is in between the x and y axis. I will write here. Suppose this is your y axis and this is your z axis, then its slopes are in between the x and y axis. And this plus and minus sign, it is called as a symmetry sign. It's called as a symmetry sign. So this is the one set of orbital. This is one set of orbital. This set is called as a one set. And this set is also called as T2G set. This set is also called as what? It is also called as a T2G set. The name of this set is T2G set. Please remember this. So T2G set contains which orbital? T2G sets contain which orbital? So these orbital. T2G set dxy, dxz and dyz. These orbitals, they are kept in one set, and that name of that set is T2G set. The name of this set is called as a T2G set because of these all three orbital, they have same energy. They have same energy. That's why they are put in T2G set or one set. Okay, so this is the first three orbital or first set that is called as a T2G set. Then the next is dx square minus y square. The next is dx square minus y square. Okay, for example, if you see here, this is the x axis and this is y axis, and this dx square minus y square has their lobes along the x and y axis. Along the x and y axis. So here I will write, suppose this is your x set, this is your y axis, then their lobes along the x and y axis. Their lobe is along the x and y axis. So this is called as a dx square minus y square. Now आप लोगों को पता चल गया होगा what is the difference between dx square minus y square and dxy. So now you understood what is the difference between dx square minus y square and dxy. Dxy has their lobes in between the x and y axis, while dx square minus y square has their lobes pointed along the x and y axis. Along the x and y axis. Okay? Okay. Then the last orbital is dz square. The last orbital is dz square, and dz square orbital has their lobes along the z axis. Dx square minus y square has their lobes along the z axis. This is z axis, and its lobes along the z axis mein hota hai. Theek hai? So these are the shapes of the d orbital. These are the shapes of the d orbital, and these two orbital, that is dx square minus y square and dz square, they are kept in another set, and the name of that set is called as a eg. The name of that set is called as a eg, and these two orbital, they have their energy similar. Iska dx square minus y square ka and dz square ka energy same hi hota hai. Theek hai? So the energy of dx square minus y square and dz square is same. That's why they are kept in another set called as a eg. Another set, it is called as a EG set. These orbital, they are called as a T2G set, and another two orbital, they are called as a EG set. So please remember this. Okay? If you understood this, then we will go to the next one. Agar aap logo ko ye pata acche se samajh mein aa gaya, then we will go to the next point. Okay? Yes or no? Okay, good. Very good. Then this is very, very important. This is very, very important. Please remember this, or if you have pen and notebook, you can write down this sentence. According to the CFT, according to the crystal fill theory, during the octahedral complex formation, the approach of ligands are along the axis. According to the CFT, CFT kya consider karta hai? CFT considers the attack of ligand or approach of the ligand during the octahedral complexes is along the axis. जब ऑक्टाहेड्रल कॉम्प्लेक्स फॉर्म हो जाता है तब अप्रोच ऑफ द लिगैंड इज अलोंग द एक्सिस. फॉर एग्जांपल दिस इज ऑक्टाहेड्रल कॉम्प्लेक्स. आई विल राइट हियर, दिस इज ऑक्टाहेड्रल कॉम्प्लेक्स. मेटल इज इन सेंटर एंड दीज आर फोर लिगैंड्स आर देयर. ठीक है, फोर लिगैंड्स आर देयर एंड दिस इज द octahedral geometry. This is octahedral geometry. And if you take this axis, if you consider this axis as a x-axis, this axis as a y-axis, and this upper axis as a z-axis, then this axis will become y dash. ये क्या हो जाएगा? Y dash हो जाएगा. This will become x dash and this will become z dash. ठीक है, जे डैस एंड द फोर लिगैंड्स दे आर प्लेस्ड अलोंग द ऑन द एक्सिस. दीज फोर लिगैंड्स दे आर प्लेस्ड ऑन द एक्सिस. दैट मीन्स द अप्रोच ऑफ द लिगैंड्स ड्यूरिंग द ऑक्टेट. वन लिगैंड इज हियर आल्सो एंड अनदर लिगैंड इज हियर आल्सो. ठीक है, सो दैट मीन्स व्हाट? ड्यूरिंग द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ ऑक्टाहेड्रल कॉम्प्लेक्सेस, ड्यूरिंग द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ ऑक्टाहेड्रल कॉम्प्लेक्सेस अप्रोच ऑफ द लिगैंड्स आर अलोंग द एक्सिस. अप्रोच ऑफ द लिगैंड्स आर अलोंग द एक्सिस. जब भी ऑक्टाहेड्रल कॉम्प्लेक्स फॉर्म हो जाता है तब अप्रोच ऑफ द लिगैंड वो अलोंग द एक्सिस होता है. नाउ सी हियर, दिस इज द परफेक्ट ऑक्टाहेड्रल. इन द सेंटर मेटल इज देयर. हियर वन लिगैंड इज देयर, अनदर लिगैंड इज हियर, थर्ड वन इज हियर, फोर्थ वन, फिफ्थ इज अबव द लिगैंड, अबव द प्लेन, एंड सिक्स्थ इज बिलो द प्लेन. एंड दिस एक्सिस इज अ जेड एक्सिस. दिस एक्सिस इज कॉल्ड एज अ जेड. This is called as a y-axis and this is called as a x-axis. So, according to the CFT, during the octahedral complex formation, the approach of the ligand is along the axis. ये आप लोगों को ध्यान में रखना चाहिए. So, CFT considers that the approach of the ligand during the octahedral complex formation is along the axis. ठीक है, सो दिस इज द वेरी 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 इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट. इफ यू हैव पेन नोटबुक यू कैन राइट डाउन दिस पॉइंट. अकॉर्डिंग टू द सीएफटी ड्यूरिंग द ऑक्टाहेड्रल कॉम्प्लेक्स फॉर्मेशन द अप्रोच ऑफ द लिगैंड्स आर अलोंग द एक्सिस. देन द सेकंड पॉइंट इज व्हाट? अकॉर्डिंग टू द सीएफटी ड्यूरिंग द टेट्राहेड्रल कॉम्प्लेक्स फॉर्मेशन. नाउ यू सी हियर, during the tetrahedral complex formation the approach of the ligands are in between the axes. During the tetrahedral complex formation the approach of the ligands are in between the axes. For example, here metal is, you have metal, and for tetrahedral complexes that means coordination number is 4, and that means 4 ligands are joined to the central metal atom. So these 4 ligands are there, and here if you consider this axis as a z axis, then this axis as a x axis, and this axis which is coming towards you is called as a y axis. Then this axis we will call it as a x dash. This axis which is going backward is called as a y dash, and this axis which is coming downward which is called as z dash. So during the formation of tetrahedral complex the approach of the ligands is in between the axes. See here, x axis is here, z axis is here, and this ligand is placed in between the x and z axis. And if you keep this tetrahedral in a cube, then you will come to know that the approach of the ligand or the bond are in between the axes. Okay, so this is the second point which is also very very important. According to the CFT, during the tetrahedral complex formation the approach of the ligands are in between the axes. Ye do points aap logo ko dhyan mein rakhne hai, then and then only you will understand the CFT completely. Okay, so ye do point aap logo ko dhyan mein rakhne chahiye. Which two points? First point is during the octahedral complex formation the approach of the ligands are along the axis, and second point is during the tetrahedral complex formation the approach of the ligand is or are in between the axes. These two points are there which is very very important. ये आप लोगों को ध्यान में रखना चाहिए. ठीक है, understood these two points? समझ में आ गया सर? बोलो सर. ये दो पॉइंट्स हमें अच्छी तरह से समझ में आ गए. ठीक है, किस किस को समझ में आया, टेल मी दिस टू पॉइंट्स. ठीक है, अगर आप लोगों को समझ में आए देन वी विल गो टू द नेक्स्ट नेक्स्ट पॉइंट और वी विल गो टू द अजम्पशंस ऑफ सीएफटी. वी विल गो टू द अजम्पशंस ऑफ सीएफटी देन. ओके, ग्रीशा इज सेइंग यस सर. सौरभ, रोहन, अनिशा, ओके गुड, दैट मींस यू हैव अंडरस्टूड अंडरस्टूड द टू पॉइंट सर. जय इज सेइंग, कृष्ण प्रिया इज ऑल्सो सेइंग, विक्रम, नेहा, सुप्रिया. Okay, very good. So if you have pen and notebook, then write down this point and draw this figure also. These points will be helpful to you people. ठीक है, जब आप लोग splitting of the d orbitals देखोगे ना, then these two points will be the helpful. This we will use these two points during the splitting of d orbital during the complex formation. We will see the application of CFT to the tetrahedral complexes also. We will see the application of CFT to the octahedral complexes also and square planar complexes also. So the splitting of the d orbital in case of tetrahedral complexes, in case of octahedral complexes and in case of square planar complexes is different. Octahedral का different होता है splitting, tetrahedral का different होता है and square planar का different होता है. So why the different splitting is there? It is because of the approach of the ligand. It is because of the approach of ligand. ठीक है? Okay. Then we will go to the one more important point. It is called as a group theoretical symbol. It is called as a group theoretical symbols. Okay. So if you see here, I will write here one diagram. So I will write here 5d orbital 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So these are 5d orbital. 5d orbital. So this d orbital. Suppose here energy is there. Suppose here energy. Energy is there. So this d orbital, they have same in energy. They are degenerate. They have same in energy. That's why they are called as a degenerate. D-E-G-E-R-A-N-A-T. So they are called as a degenerate orbital. So this condition of the d orbital is in free metal ion. So in free metal ion, all the d orbitals, they are degenerate. In the free metal ion, all the d orbital, they are degenerate. That means they have same energy or equal energy. Now what happens after the complex formation? So after the complex formation, according to the CFT, these two orbital or these 5d orbital, they will get divided into two set. So this first set is called as a T2G set and this another set is called as a EG set. So why these two sets? Now this 3d orbital dxy, dxz and dyz, so they have their same energy or equal energy. That's why these 3d orbital, they are called as a degenerate orbital. T2g all are called as a degenerate orbital. And this eg, which eg orbitals are these? ये कौन सी इजी ऑर्बिटल है? कैन एनीबडी टेल मी देन नेम ऑफ दिस टू इजी ऑर्बिटल व्हिच हैज सेम एनर्जी और इक्वल एनर्जी. द नेम ऑफ दिस टू ऑर्बिटल क्या है? है किसी को पता? द फर्स्ट ऑर्बिटल इज कॉल्ड एज ए dx square minus y square and another one is called as a dz square, and these two orbital, they have same energy. These two orbital, they have same energy. So this is the splitting of, this is ye jo aap logo ko dikh rahe na, this one, this is the splitting of d orbital in octahedral field. So this is the splitting of d orbital in octahedral field or octahedral complex. When octahedral complex will form, then this 5d orbital, they will divide into two set. First set is called as a T2g set and another set is called as a EG set. Now this energy of EG orbital is higher. Energy of EG orbital is higher than the T2g orbital. Energy of here I will write, energy of EG set is higher than T2g set. The energy of EG orbital is higher than T2g set. and this difference in energy, this difference in energy is called as a del O. This difference in energy is called as a del O. Please remember this. This difference in energy is called as a del O. Theek hai? Understood this, the splitting of d orbital into octahedral field? Yes or no? The energy of EG orbital is higher than the energy of T2G orbital. Our T2G orbital will have lower in energy and EG orbital will get in higher in energy. So this is the splitting of d orbital in octahedral complex or octahedral field. Theek hai? Okay. Then we will see the meaning or group theoretical symbols of T2G orbital. Why this T2G set, or the what is the meaning of this T2G set? So this here T2G means triply degenerate orbital. Triply degenerate, that means what? There are 3 d orbitals. Triply means there are 3 d orbitals which are degenerate. There are 3 d orbitals which are degenerate. That means 3 d orbitals are there, and that 3 d orbital has a same energy or equal in energy. That's why T2G symbol is there. So what is this T? T means 3 degenerate orbital. T means what? 3 degenerate orbital. And symbol G means what? Symbol G means it is called as a Z-rayed. It is called as a Z-rayed. This is a German word. This Z-rayed, it is a German word. The meaning or long form of G is Z-rayed. It is a German word, and meaning of this German word is even. Meaning of this German word Z-rayed. Z-rayed ka kya meaning hota hai? The meaning of Z-rayed is even. The meaning of Z-rayed is even. And one more symbol is there, which is called as a U, and it is called as a un-Z-rayed. Which is called as un-Z-rayed. It is also a German word. It is also a German word and meaning uneven. And the meaning of un-Z-rayed is uneven. So this is the group theoretical symbol. This is the group theoretical symbol. Okay. Now, why this G and what is this U? What is the meaning of this G and U? Or when the orbital it is called as a Z-rayed orbital, and when the orbital which is called as a un-Z-rayed orbital? So it depends upon the centrosymmetric orbital. If the orbital is centrosymmetric, if the orbital is centrosymmetric, then Z-rayed is there. When Z-rayed is written, when G is written, if the orbital is centrosymmetric, when the orbital is centrosymmetric, or it is also called as a center of symmetry, which is also called as a center of symmetry, or it is also called as a inversion center. Inversion center. Apne organic chemistry mein ye naam sune honge. That is center of symmetry and inversion center. So what is this center of symmetry? If the orbital has a center of symmetry, or if the orbital has an inversion center, then that orbital is called as a centrosymmetric orbital. Then that orbital is called as a centrosymmetric orbital. And if the orbital is centrosymmetric, then G is written. If the orbital is centrosymmetric, then G is written. Okay. And if the orbital does not has a center of symmetry or inversion center, then that orbital is called as a non-centrosymmetric orbital. Then that orbital are called as non-centrosymmetric orbital. And in case of non-centrosymmetric orbital, the symbol U is written. The symbol U is written. Please remember this. So when to write Z-rayed or when to write un-Z-rayed, it depends upon the type of orbital. If the orbital is centrosymmetric orbital, that means that orbital has a center of symmetry or inversion center, then that orbital is called as a centrosymmetric orbital, and you will write the symbol G. And if the center of symmetry is absent or inversion center is absent, then that orbital is called as a non-centrosymmetric orbital. Then that orbital is called as non-centrosymmetric orbital, and for such orbital the symbol U is written. And for the such non-centrosymmetric orbital, the symbol U is written. Now, how to determine whether the given orbital is centrosymmetric, or that contains center of symmetry, or that orbital has a center inversion center? So let us consider this example. So this is dxy orbital, this is dx orbital, and if you see, this is your center, and okay, let us consider this is your center of your orbital, and if you go from this center to this side, there is plus sign. If you go from this center to this side, there is a plus sign, and exactly opposite to this side, you will go at 180 degree. If you will go, and you will get the same plus sign, you will get the same plus sign, then you can say that this orbital has a center of symmetry. This orbital has a center of symmetry, or it is called as a inversion center. Now here also, now see here also, if you go from this point, here plus sign is there, and you will go here, here minus sign is there. That means this orbital is a centrosymmetric orbital. If this condition is there, then it is called as a centrosymmetric orbital, or it is also called as a, which this orbital has a center of symmetry. If you keep this center as a point as a center, then from this point each side pe plus sign hai, yahan pe bhi plus sign hai. So this condition is there, then it is called as a center of symmetry, inversion of, say, inversion center or inversion point is inversion point. It is also called as a inversion point. So this is dxy orbital is called as a centrosymmetric orbital, and you will write this as a symbol g. Okay. So all the d orbital which has center of symmetry, all the d orbital has center of symmetry. All d orbital has center of symmetry. Please remember this. All आप लोगों ने देखा होगा कि ये जो orbitals है कौन से dx. अगर आपने for example यहाँ पे, for example this is y axis and this is z axis, then minus sign is there, here also minus sign, here plus sign, here plus sign. So this point is called as a center of symmetry and centrosymmetric. Okay, so all the d orbital, they have a center of symmetry, all the d orbital they have center of symmetry. So while writing the d orbital, you have to write the symbol g. So here t to g is there, here I have written, here I have written g, and while writing e orbital I have written g. So the d orbitals are centrosymmetric orbital, that's why I have written g. Okay, then next point, see here, s and g orbitals, they are called as a, s and d orbital, d is also there, they are called as a z-rayed orbital, they are called as a z-rayed orbital, and p and f orbital, they are called as a un-z-rayed orbital. P and f orbital, they are called as a un-z-rayed orbital. Now let us talk about the p orbital. Now let us see px, let us see px orbital. So px orbital, that means the lobes of px orbital lies along the x-axis, the lobes of px orbital lies along the x-axis, and if you draw the p orbital, here plus symbol is there and here minus symbol is there, and if you consider this, this is your center, and you, if you go from this side, that is left side, here plus sign is there, and if you go, that is right side, here minus sign is there. So sign is different, so sign is different, so this orbital is called as a non-centrosymmetric orbital, non-centrosymmetric orbital. All p orbitals, they are non-centrosymmetric. All the p orbitals, they are non-centrosymmetric. So while writing the symbol of p orbital, you have to write u. You have to write u. Don't write g over there. Okay. While writing all the p orbital, while writing all the f orbital, you have to write the symbol u and not g. Please remember this. So for those orbital which has a center of symmetry, that orbital you can write a g symbol, and non-centrosymmetric के लिए आप लोग क्या 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 write करोगे, symbol U. Okay? So this is the group theoretical symbol. It is called as a group theoretical symbol. It is also called as a symmetry symbol also. It is also called as a symmetry symbol. Detail you will study while in MSc part 1. Detail you will study while studying the subject symmetry and group theory. Symmetry is a very big subject hai, MSc ko. In that subject you will study the what is the T2G, what is TUG, what are the different parity symbol is there. ठीक है तो आप लोग वो symmetry chapter में देखोगे while studying MSc part 1. Then let us come to the another set that is called as a EG set. Let us come to the another set, it is called as a EG set. So EG orbital, that means they are EG orbital is there, so it is called as a doubly degenerate orbital. Why it is called as a doubly degenerate? As it contains 2d orbital which has same in energy. 2d orbital which has same energy. That's why it is called as a doubly degenerate. The meaning of E is called as a doubly degenerate. Meaning of T is called as a triply degenerate. So E is called as a 2d degenerate orbitals. E, the symbol E is used for 2 generate orbital, and here also symbol G which is a German word G red, which is meaning E1, and it is written for centrosymmetric. It is written for centrosymmetric orbital. For example, let us consider this orbital dx square minus y square. Let us consider this orbital, that is dx square minus y. Dx square minus y square, and let us consider this is your center. Let us consider this is your center, and if you go from this center to the upward, minus sign is there, and from this center if you go downward, then minus sign is there. So similar sign is there, exactly 180 degree opposite direction. Then these orbital is called as a centrosymmetric orbital, or this orbital contains a center of symmetry or inversion center. So due to this it is called as a centrosymmetric orbital, and for centrosymmetric orbital you will write the symbol Z. You will write the symbol Z. And one more orbital is there, this orbital dz square. Dz square ka kya hota hai? Ye hota hai. Suppose this is z orbital, then its lobe has a along the z axis here positive sign is there, here also positive sign, here negative sign, and here negative sign. And if you consider this is your center, then plus sign is present, here also plus sign is present. From this side to right side pe bhi negative sign hai, or left pe bhi negative sign hai. So this dz square orbital, it is also called as a centrosymmetric orbital. That's why the symbol G is written. That's why the symbol G is written. So these are the group theoretical symbols. So these are the group theoretical symbols. अब मुझे जल्दी से बोलो किस किस को समझ में आया, किस किस को समझ में आया कि सर मुझे group theoretical symbols T2G and EG orbital के समझ में आए हैं? ऐसे कौन कौन से बच्चे हैं? Please tell me. ठीक है? किसको समझ में आया? Tell me. ओके कृष्ण प्रिया इज सेइंग यस सर, सिर्फ कृष्ण प्रिया को ही समझ में आया लगता है. ग्रीषा को भी आया है, सुप्रिया को भी आया है, अंकुश जय. ओके ठीक है, अगर आपको यह समझ में नहीं आया है तो आई विल गिव द वीडियो ऑफ दिस लेक्चर आल्सो. यू कैन सी द वीडियो मेनी टाइम, यू कैन सी द वीडियो. इफ यू अंडरस्टैंड दिस ग्रुप थ्योरेटिकल सिंबल, then only we will go to the next point. Then only we will go next point. ठीक है, जब तक आपको ये group theoretical symbol समझ में नहीं आया है तब तब आप लोग आगे नहीं जाओगे. ठीक है, ठीक है, याद में रखो. अगर समझ में आए then it is very good. अगर आपको first lecture में और first attempt में ही समझ में आए then you are, I can say you you people are intelligent people. ठीक है, अगर आपको first attempt में ही समझ में आ गया तो आप लोग भाई अच्छी है आपकी memory. ठीक है, ओके. सो वी विल गो टू द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट व्हिच इज अजम्पशंस. नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इज अजम्पशंस ऑफ वैलेंस, सॉरी अजम्पशंस ऑफ क्रिस्टल फील्ड थ्योरी, दैट इज सीएफटी. हम लोगों ने VBTK bhi kuch assumptions dekhe. So there are some points, important points or key points, that points you have to remember or understood, so as you can tabhi aap logo ko crystal field theory samajh mein aayegi. Theek hai, to first let us see the assumptions of crystal field theory. So first assumptions hai ke screen pe, according to the crystal field theory, ligands are point charges or point dipoles. According to the first assumptions of crystal field theory, ligands are point charges or point dipoles. That means the ligand can has a two dipole, or ligand can have a negative dipole or positive dipole. Okay, so according to the CFT, this is the first assumption. For example, let us see the water molecule. Let us see water molecule H2O. So oxygen is electronegative, it will have a negative charge. Hydrogens are electropositive, it will have a positive charge. So according to the CFT, ligands are treated as a point charges or point dipoles. Here negative dipole is there and here two positive dipoles is there. Okay, so this is the first assumption. Second assumption is the attraction between metal ion. Second assumption is the attraction between metal ion and ligand is purely electrostatic. The attraction between metal ion and ligand is purely electrostatic. ठीक है, क्यों electrostatic है? Because this theory consider ligand as a dipole and metal as a ligand. में दो dipole होते, negative and positive, and metal is positively charged. So negative positive electrostatic attraction will be there, and if the electrostatic attraction is there, that bond is called as a ionic bond. If the electrostatic attraction is there, then that bond is called as a ionic bond. So according to the second assumptions of crystal field theory, the attraction between metal and ligand is purely electrostatic. That is, the bond formed between central metal atom and ligand is 100% ionic. The bond formed between central metal atom and ligand is 100% ionic according to the CFT. According to the CFT. Now you people tell me, according to the VBT. Now आप लोगों को मुझे बोलना है, according to the VBT, the bond formed between metal and ligand is ionic, covalent or metallic according to the VBT. कौन सा होता है bond? According to the VBT, the bond between metal atom and ligand is, which bond is present in between metal and ligand according to the valence bond theory? Correct, Armia, very good. According to the valence bond theory, the bond between metal atom and ligand is covalent. And according to the CFT, the bond between metal atom and ligand is not covalent. It is a 100% ionic. It is a 100% ionic. So this theory, crystal field theory, considers the bond between metal atom and ligand is ionic bond. This theory does not considers the covalent bond. So one more theory is there, that theory considers the bond between metal atom and ligand is ionic as well as covalent. That theory is called as a ligand field theory. But that theory we will not discuss here. We will discuss only crystal field theory. So this is the second assumption. Then third assumption is the CFT considers, the splitting of d orbitals into two energy level during the complex formation. ये हम लोगों ने पहले देखा है. According to the crystal field theory, d orbital splits into two different energy level during the complex formation. और कौन से दो एनर्जी लेवल है हम लोगों ने देखा है, दैट इज T2g एंड Eg ऑर्बिटल. सो CFT कंसीडर द स्प्लिटिंग ऑफ d ऑर्बिटल्स इनटू टू एनर्जी लेवल ड्यूरिंग द कॉम्प्लेक्स फॉर्मेशन. एंड अकॉर्डिंग टू द वैलेंस बॉन्ड थ्योरी, देयर इज नो स्प्लिटिंग ऑफ ऑर्बिटल, d ऑर्बिटल टेक्स प्लेस. द d ऑर्बिटल आफ्टर द कॉम्प्लेक्स फॉर्मेशन दे आर सेम इन एनर्जी, एंड बिफोर द कॉम्प्लेक्स फॉर्मेशन दे आर same in energy. That means the energy of d orbital after the complex formation and before the complex formation, according to the valence bond theory, is same. According to the valence bond theory, the energy of d orbital before the complex and after the complex is same. But according to the CFT, the energy of d orbital after the complex formation and before the complex formation is different. Before the complex formation, all the d orbital they are degenerate, and after the complex formation there is a splitting of d orbital takes place. Splitting of d orbital into two energy level takes place. So the energy, the orbital which are lower in energy, that orbital are called as, kya bolte usko, bolo. Those orbitals which are lower in energy, according to the CFT, that orbital is called as what? Maine bola aap logo ko. That orbital is called as दो सेट्स हम लोगों ने देखे थे, ठीक है, करेक्ट, वेरी गुड कृष्णप्रिया, दैट ऑर्बिटल इज कॉल्ड एज अ T2g ऑर्बिटल एंड द ऑर्बिटल व्हिच हैज हायर एनर्जी देन T2g ऑर्बिटल दे आर कॉल्ड एज EG ऑर्बिटल, दे आर कॉल्ड एज EG ऑर्बिटल. सो दिस इज द थर्ड एंड वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट अजम्पशंस ऑफ क्रिस्टल फील्ड थ्योरी. दिस इज थर्ड एंड इंपॉर्टेंट अजम्पशंस ऑफ क्रिस्टल फील्ड थ्योरी. देन वी विल सी द नेक्स्ट अजम्पशन. The interaction between electrons of metal cation and those of ligands are entirely repulsive. According to the crystal field theory or CFT, the interaction between metal cation and ligand is entirely repulsive. So why the interaction is repulsive? Why interaction is repulsive? Because your ligands that contains a negatively charged atoms, your ligand contains negatively charged atoms, and your metal has d electrons, and that electrons is also negatively charged. Metal contains d electrons, your ligands are negatively charged, so negative repulsion will be there. Negative repulsion will be there. So according to the crystal field theory, interaction between electrons of the metal cation and those of the ligands are entirely repulsive, and these repulsive forces are responsible for the splitting of d orbital of the central metal ion. So why splitting of d orbital takes place? Why splitting of d orbital takes place? Because of the repulsion between my electrons of metal and negative charge of the ligands. So negative repulsion will be there, and these repulsive forces are responsible for the splitting of d orbital. So the cause of the d orbital splitting is the repulsive forces. The cause of d orbital splitting is repulsive forces, and these repulsive forces is present due to the negatively electrons of metal cation and negatively charged ligand. So this is the fourth assumption. I will read one more time this assumption. The interaction between electrons of metal cation and those of ligands are entirely repulsive, and these repulsive forces are responsible for the splitting of d orbital of central metal atom. Okay, so this is the fourth assumption. Then the next assumptions, fifth assumptions is according to this theory ligands are either negative ions. According to this theory, ligands are either negative ions like cyanide minus, chloride minus, or they are neutral molecules like H2O and NH3. According to this theory, ligands are either negative or they are neutral molecules such as H2O and NH3. And if the ligands are neutral, for example H2O and NH3, then the negative end is directed towards the central metal ion. And if the ligand is negative or neutral, then the negative end of that ligand is directed towards the central metal atom. For example, let us see one example. For example, your metal is here, and let us consider this neutral ligand, let us consider this NH3. Now here two lone pairs are present on nitrogen atom, so it will have negative charge. This hydrogen will have positive charge, and according to this theory, ligands are neutral, then the negative N is directed towards the central metal ion. So the negative N is directed towards the central metal atom. So this is the fifth assumption. ठीक है, समझ में आ गया फिफ्थ assumption? ओके, देन वी विल गो टू द नेक्स्ट लास्ट assumptions, assumptions नंबर सिक्स. What is the sixth assumption? The nature and strength of ligands. The nature and strength of ligand determines the types of complex. The nature and strength of the ligands determines the types of complex, that is strong field complex or weak field complex. So whether the complex is strong field or weak field, it depends upon the nature of ligand. It depends upon the nature of the ligand. If the ligand is strong field ligand, if the ligand is strong field ligand, then the complex formed by that ligand is strong field complex. And if the ligand is weak field, then the complex formed by such ligands are called as weak field complexes. So the nature of ligand or the nature of complex is depends upon the nature of ligand. If the ligand is strong field, then the complex is called as a strong field complexes, and if the ligand is weak field, then the complex is called as a weak field complexes. So this is the sixth and last assumptions. Okay, so we have finished the assumption of crystal field theory. So if you understood the assumption of crystal field theory, then not today, tomorrow or in the next lecture we will see the application of assumptions of crystal field theory to the strong tetrahedral complexes, octahedral complexes and square planar complexes. ठीक है, ठीक है, yes or no? Have you understood the assumptions or not? Okay sir, संस्कृति को समझ में आया, very good, very good. कोमल, विक्रम, ग्रीषा, अंकुश, ठीक है. सो आई थिंक वी विल स्टॉप हियर. If you have any doubt, any problem, you can ask me. Related to today's lecture. आज के लेक्चर में कुछ प्रॉब्लम्स, कुछ डाउट्स है तो आप लोग मुझे पूछ सकते हो. साक्षी, विश्वजीत, प्रियंका, बोलो जल्दी से. कुछ डाउट है? No doubt. Shall I stop here? Sir, when will be having our college exam? Which exam? Are we talking about internal or final exam? Pradnya. Which exam are you talking about? University examination, both. Prachi is saying both. University examination you will have after your the first term. ये first term के बाद में आप लोगों के university exam हो जाएंगे. Don't worry about that. So your first term is I think up to the 5 December, 5th of December ना, 5th of December तक है ना. So in December you will have your university examination. In December you will have, and internal examination. Internal examination, I don't know. Internal examination, I don't know, but I will give you the marks as per the 4 test only. I will make the average of that 4 test and will give you, I will convert that marks into the 10 out of 10 and I will give that marks. Don't worry about that. Sure sir, thank you. Grisha is saying sure sir, thank you. Supriya, offline or online? Offline or online, even God don't know. Syllabus for what? Pradnesh Singh, syllabus for what? Internal exam? Sir, university exam will be offline or online? That I don't know. But I think both option will be there. बहुत ऑप्शन विल बी देयर. अभी जो टीवाई के बच्चे हैं वो लोग दे आर यूजिंग बोथ मोड, दे आर यूजिंग ऑफलाइन मोड एज वेल एज दे आर यूजिंग ऑनलाइन मोड आल्सो. ठीक है, सो मे बी सेम कंडीशंस विल बी देयर. आप लोग ऑफलाइन भी दे सकते हो, ऑनलाइन भी दे सकते हो, डोंट वरी. इंटरनल एग्जामिनेशन का तो मैंने बोल दिया आप लोगों को. यार आप लोग मुझे जो आंसर और जो क्वेश्चंस खुद यूनिवर्सिटी को भी पता नहीं वो उसका आंसर आप लोग मुझसे ले रहे हो. प्लीज आस्क मी अबाउट इनऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री यार. प्लीज आस्क मी अबाउट वीवीटी एमओटी कोऑर्डिनेशन कंपाउंड्स. आप लोग मुझे ऐसे पूछते हो कि मैं वाइस चांसलर ही यूनिवर्सिटी का. ये देखो कॉलेज कब खुलने वाला है. अरे यू कैन आस्क टू आवर व्हाट वी कैन से चीफ मिनिस्टर. आई डोंट नो दैट यार. यू कैन आस्क मी अबाउट इनऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री, एनी टॉपिक ऑफ इनऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री. What after Diwali, Saurabh? After Diwali ke baad kya? Diwali is in next month. What you heard, Saurabh? कॉलेज नो कांट से कॉलेज नहीं खुलने वाला दिवाली के बाद भी. ओके सो नो प्रॉब्लम, सो आई विल स्टॉप हियर. कैन वी टेक लेक्चर टुमारो? आर यू फ्री टुमारो? क्योंकि कल हम लोगों का मिस हुआ था ना. अगर आप लोग फ्री हो टुमारो सो वी विल कंडक्ट वन लेक्चर टुमारो आल्सो, नो प्रॉब्लम. आर यू फ्री टुमारो? प्लीज टेल मी. ग्रीशा इज सेइंग यस सर, ग्रीशा इज फ्री. ओके गुड, वेरी गुड. सो टुमारो Tomorrow at 3:30. What do you think? Yes or no? Tomorrow at 3:30. Okay, Mihir, Vishwajit, Supriya, Saurav, they are saying yes. So we will meet tomorrow at 3:30. No problem. ओके. थैंक यू. सो वी विल मीट टुमारो. चलो सो आई विल स्टॉप हियर. Yes or no? Okay. Bye bye. Thank you.